Ouais. Yeah, comment tu t'appelles? J'ai eu des fiers, et le magie. T'as dit que spin, yeah, tu sois ganaré. Au secours la paix, malo à tempted, yo. C'est what's my name? Bon, daddy, big tunes, got the club banging. Less man, more baddies. What's that? It's a drop top caddy. What's my name? Bob Daddy. Big tunes, got the club banging. Less man, more baddies. What's that? It's a drop top caddy. Hey, Bob Daddy, Bob Daddy, Bob, Bob, Bob Daddy, Bob Daddy, Bob Daddy, Bob, Bob, Bob Daddy, Bob Daddy, Bob Daddy. Bob Daddy. What? Yeah, comment tu t'appelles? J'ai eu des fiers. Et le magie, t'as dit que spin, yeah, tu sois ganaré, au secours la paix, malo à tempted, yo. C'est what's my name? Bob Daddy, big tunes, got the club banging. Less man, more baddies. What's that? It's a drop top caddy. What's my name? Bob Daddy, big tunes, got the club banging.
Stop ya, stop ya, stop ya, stop, 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 stop. What is it? Big Daddy, Big Daddy, what's my name? Big Daddy, Big Daddy, call little small mommy. All of you, you are already dancing. If we invite you to church now, you will not come to church. Even when we force you to church, they will be singing praise the Lord in church. You will not be able to dance. But you are Big Daddy, Big Daddy. You are already there. I know some of you girls are already twerking. Big Daddy, Big Daddy. Oh, you better go and give your life to Christ. Sure.
Can't stay here, asleep to how you're moving. I can't stay here, complacent anymore. I can't stay here. My heart is full of longing. I can't stay here. I know what I'm made for. You're breathing new life into dry bones. I hear the echo, the sound of heaven's song. Your spirit's calling me. I know it's time to go. I can't stay here anymore.
Do you feel like there's something inside of you that wants to come out? Do you feel like you are caged? Like you want to break out? Do you feel like you're in a prison? I'm not talking about prison with walls. Like you feel like you are caged. There's something inside of you that is burning to get out. Do you have a yearning inside of you? Do you have a desire, a goal that you have kept inside of you all these years that it's burning, it's fighting you? Do you feel that burden on your chest? Do you feel that weight inside of you, that thing that you've been longing for? You might not have an idea of what that thing is, but there's something inside of you that you know is crying out inside of you that want to burst out. If you are that person, God sent me to you today. My message today is for you. Just like you've heard in the background song that you can't stay here, it's time to go. There's something inside of you. There's a destiny inside of you. There's a champion inside of you that is crying. You know it. You feel it. You see it every day. Every time you see something that looks like that thing that is yearning inside of you, there's that thing inside of you that jumps. There's something inside of you waiting to come out. That creation, that invention, that business, that thing that you want to start. I don't know whatever that thing is. But I know that there's somebody right now watching me right now. You feel that burden inside your heart. And if you are that person, then this message is for you. As usual, my name is Ayodeji Onifade, and here are the three things that I learned this week. You know, like I was saying, you know, if you are that person that has that kind of a burden inside of you, you have this thing, that passion that you want to feel in life. You have that burden, you know, like that's this emptiness that until you do those things, you are not going to be free. And if you are that person, then here are the three things that I have to say to you. Number one is that if you feel that, then you must know that it is time for you to go. You know, there are times in our life that we have a destiny to fulfill. Not there are times in our life. The reason why we are here in the first place is that there is something God put us on earth for us to come and fulfill. And if you are that person right now that you feel this yearning, you know, anytime you find yourself doing something that you are not fulfilled, you are not satisfied, there are things that are inside of you, I want to tell you that this is the time for you to bust out. You can't stay where you are right now. It could be that you are in a particular job right now and you're not finding fulfillment in that job right now. Hey, I'm not asking anybody to go quit their job here. That is not what I'm saying. But I'm saying that if you know inside of you that until you do that thing, you cannot rest. Or maybe you are somewhere and all of a sudden you just feel like that place doesn't feel right anymore. Then you must know it is time to go. Habakkuk 2 verse 3 says that for the vision is for an appointed time. There is a point in time in our life when it gets to a point where you know it is time for you to go to the next level. Every stage we are in our life, there's a time and a season for it. And when that time and season end, it's only natural for that thing inside of you to call for you to get into the next season of your life. And that is why today's message is for those of us who are in that kind of a position right now, that we feel that it is right for us to go into that next season of our life. You know, Habakkuk 3 says that for the vision is for an appointed time. He said, yes, though it may tarry, he said, but wait for it. You know, the waiting in there is not a passive kind of waiting where you just sit down and you do nothing. No, the waiting is actually an activeness where you are dread to the calling and the yearning inside of you. He said, dude, it is for an appointment. Don't you tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come. And I want to assure you right now that the feeling that you are feeling right now, it is not just, it's nothing. It's the Spirit of God trying to tell you that it is time for you to move. Are you somewhere you are not supposed to be right now? I want to tell you it's time for you to move. Even the children of Israel, when God took them out of Egypt and he brought them into the wilderness at Mount Sinai, and they were with God, you know, for a while, and it got to a point, God said, what are you guys doing here? It is time for you to move. They stood in the presence of God and it felt like they were going to be there forever. Some of you might feel like you are in that position that you are right now forever. It is time for you to move. I'm telling you right now, don't be afraid. Take that step. It is time for you to move. And the second thing I want to tell you about is that, said, don't discard or lose sight of your dreams. You know, those things that has been inside of you for years, those dreams that you have, look, this is the time for you to go up. Don't discard them. The fact that you are still having those dreams, the fact that those things are still crying inside of you, is a testament that there is still a chance that dreams will come to fulfillment. I was reading the book of Richard Carswell, and I think I've said it on my video here before. He said, those of us who have a dream, who have this desire, who have this longing, that pushing that you're having right now, he said, for the fact that you have those dreams, you have those longing, you have those pushing, also means that you have the capacity and the capability to bring those dreams to pass. You know, just like Habakkuk 2 verse 3, he said, for the vision is for an appointed time. He said, though it tarry, wait for it, because it will not tarry, it will surely come. Dreams do come true. A friend of mine was talking about me, who has dreamt of buying, you know, a particular car. I'm not going to tell who that person is and what that car is, but he has waited to buy that car for years. Do you know, eventually got to buy his cars of his dreams. And I said to him, when he told me, he said, you said this thing and you eventually got. I said, so really, dreams do come true. Look, if you have that yearning, if you have that dream, maybe you want to start a business, maybe you want to travel the world, maybe you want to start an NGO, I don't care what that dream is, dreams do come true. Please don't let go of your dreams. Don't let go of the desire that the Lord has put inside of you. Don't let go of who you are, because if you let go of that dreams, you are going to let go of who you are. You are going to let go of your fulfillment in life. Nothing else will make you fulfilled until you fulfill that dream. So don't shortchange your dreams. Don't let it go. Hold on to it. I want to assure you, dreams do come true. I've seen a lot of people who dreamt about something big and eventually came to fruition. Your dreams is not dead. Don't let that dream go. Hold on to it. The fact that you have that desire, the fact that that thing is burning inside of you, the fact that it is still pushing you right now, look, go after it with all you've got. Go after it with your mind. Go after it. And when you do it, I can assure you, it will come to pass. And the third thing is that make sure that you are ready when the time comes. This is where we get it wrong. Even when we have that longing inside of us, even when we are holding on to our dream, a lot of us are not prepared for the opportunity when it comes. And that is why you need to be ready. Look, I can assure you, that opportunity will come. That business opportunity will come. That opportunity for you to travel the world will come. That opportunity to get into that company, to get that job will come. The question is that when your dreams come facing you in your face, would you be ready to get it or to capture it with both hands? You have to prepare yourself. Like Habakkuk 2:3, I'm going to be majoring on that scripture. He said, for the vision is for an appointed time. You have to be ready for when that time comes. He said it's for an appointed time, which means it is surely going to come. Even though it tarried, it delays a little bit. He said, but it will not lie. Some versions said it will not lie, because dreams and vision and the purpose for which God created you is not a lie. It's not going to lie. That time is going to come. But the question is, when that time comes, will you be ready? They say opportunity always favor the prepared. Keep reading that book right now. Keep going for that courses. Keep putting that plans in place. Keep writing that proposal. Keep submitting those proposals. Keep doing the things that you need to do, because someday I can assure you that opportunity is going to come. I can assure you that dream is going to come. I can assure you that opportunity is going to come. But the question is, when it comes, when they call you that it is time, when the opportunities come to you, when the universe arranges, when the Holy Spirit comes to you and says, now the time is here, what would you be doing? Would you be sleeping? Or would you be ready to capture that opportunity with both hands? This message is for somebody out there. There's somebody out there, I believe in my spirit, God gave me this message for somebody, that it is not the time for you to quit on your dreams. That longing that you are having right now, that push that you're having right now, is from the Holy Spirit. Like you heard in the background music, when he said, it's time to do, he said, I'm going out of the door. It is time for you to bust that door that I have limited you, to bust it wide open and go after your dream. Because until you do that, you might not fulfill. And those are the three things that I brought to you this week. Give us a like. Like this video or leave a comment for me in the comment section. Let me know your thoughts. Let's have a conversation about this. You know, and also follow me in all of my social media platforms. Follow me on YouTube, follow me on Facebook, I'm also on Instagram. And the details will be appearing on your screen right now. And until next time, like I always say, never stop learning and always be that which God wants you to be. Peace out.
If you liked the video that you just watched on my dad's channel, please like his YouTube channel and subscribe to it. His YouTube channel's name is Ayodeji Onifade. And follow him on Facebook. His Facebook page is Ayodeji Onifade. And don't forget to follow him on Instagram. His Instagram page is Pastor Pimpim.